delighted to be joined once again by our resident Football League expert, Tony Gale, alongside Paul Walsh, of course, who played for Liverpool, Man City, Spurs, amongst others, Liverpool comedian Darren Farley, and of course, Nigel Spackman, ex-Chelsea and ex-Liverpool. I'm going to start the week, if I can, with Tony. You're on a bit of a bad run now, Tony, in fairness. Two bad picks the last 2 weeks.
Thanks for mentioning that.
The first two weeks you were on fire. So how are you looking at this weekend, Tony? What do you think?
You're putting me right under pressure now, aren't you? But I must say, I'm still ahead of the game, aren't I?
You are. So if
the punters have been following me, they're okay.
They'd be slightly up.
Because I don't want to be feeling guilty.
You look guilty.
I'm going to go for Wigan at home to beat Stoke. I think Stoke, great result against Arsenal last week, but I think Wigan have got enough to counter the maybe the direct style and the throw-ins and play their own football as well. So I'm going for a Brucey. It's going to be my Brucey bonus.
Yeah, Brucey bonus. Right. Wigan at home to beat Stoke. Paul, we're looking at you now next up. What do you fancy this weekend?
I fancy Aston Villa to bounce back. Should have maybe won on Monday night against Newcastle. Had two or three great chances in the first half, didn't take them, and I think they'll be smarting at that result. At home, very strong, and I think they've done ever so well this season. Got good balance about their team, and I think they'll have too much for Middlesbrough.
Had a couple of early chances, Paul, against Newcastle. If they'd have went in, it could have been a totally different story.
I mean, Agbon Laura had the one went through his leg 7 yards out. Lawson header just off the post. Ashley Young, lovely little turn, and Shaygiver made a very good save. Any of those had gone in, it could have been a totally different game, as you're saying. I think they've got enough in their locker, especially being at home, to turn Middlesbrough over.
Now I'm going to talk to Darren. Darren, before we go for your tip of the weekend, very, very dubious penalty during the week. Liverpool's captain, Walsh, reckons it was a stonewall penalty. Spackers thinks not a chance of a penalty. Well, what do you think?
You can look at both ways, really, you know what I mean? I think he's played for it, you know what I mean? But there's contact.
There's no rules against that penalty. You know
I mean? Yeah, but I mean, really, what does Gerrard think of it?
I don't think I've done anything wrong. she's right, either. Obviously, you know, the lad's coming at me. And he's got me, end of, and I've gone down. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I just think he's got to step up and take the pen and put it away like I did.
I mean, you were very confident taking the pen, Stevie, top corner.
Yeah, I'm a very confident person, to be honest with you. Just step up, I'm always going to stick it away, aren't I? Istanbul, Cardiff. I'll do it
anytime. So who do you fancy this weekend, Darren, if you can revert back to your normal self there?
I fancy a little pinch at Newcastle away to Fulham. Reckon confidence is going to be up on that now. Michael Owen fit again, and near Fulham, either come near the goal, are they?
Steady.
Newcastle away,
so joking here, obviously.
Yeah.
He's built up a bit of confidence amongst the fans.
I think we've got a little run now.
Yeah.
I reckon they're getting behind Kinnear now. Obviously, I have to say, Michael Owen back as well.
Yeah, but I mean, how do you think Michael is going to play, Michael?
Well, I mean, obviously I'm back, aren't I? So if I get a chance, I'm going to stick it away. Obviously, Fulham goes sad, but I think Roy Hodgson will be crying into his glass of wine with joking ale when he's finished, but keep scoring goals, that's all I'm going to do, mate, That's it.
Big price, Newcastle, 2-1. Finally, on to Spackers. I think you're going to go for the big game of the weekend. What's your thoughts on this one?
Yeah, I'm going to go for the early kick-off, Arsenal at home to Man United. I just think this is a massive game for both clubs, but I just see Man United being too strong for Arsenal. I think Arsenal defensively at the moment aren't as strong as they should be. I think they've got problems with the goalkeeper as well. I think the centre-backs as well. So I just fancy Man United to go there, play the way that Man United can, hit on the counter-attack with the pace they've got, and I think they'll turn Arsenal over.
Very dangerous up front, four world-class players. You can pick from either, whoever he wants. It's still a world-class lineup. 6-4 Man United for the away win. You're an ex-Chelsea player, you're an ex-Liverpool player. The Premier League title race is really hotting up now. It's getting very close. Spurs beating Liverpool has done the league a bit of a favour, no doubt. Chelsea are still the favourites at 5-6. United 9-4, Liverpool 9-2, Arsenal 16-1. Where would your hard-earned cash be going for the Premier League?
I won't be giving it a game there for sure. But at the start of the season, I fancied Chelsea strongly, and I'm not going to change away from that. I think, with a new manager there, a new focus, I think they'll be the team to beat. But you can't write off Man United. You can't write off Liverpool now, who are very strong. But I think you've got to write off Arsenal. I think it's a three-horse race, but I still think that Chelsea are the team to beat.
So Chelsea for you for the Premier League. Paul, I'm going to ask you about the Champions League. Chelsea and United still joint favourites at 9-2, Barcelona 11-2, Inter Milan 7, then we've got Arsenal, Madrid and Liverpool all 12-1. Juventus, a big win at the Bernabeu, as we said, under Claudio Ranieri, 16-1 for the Champions League. What's your thoughts?
Well, I did them the other night, Juventus against Real Madrid. I did both the games and they were very good in both games. very strong, but great defensively, and Del Piero still on fire, but whether or not he can keep that up all season, I don't know. I don't fancy Juventus to go all the way. I still think it's going to be one of the English teams. Barcelona are a massive threat if they play to their full potential. If I had to stick my money on anybody, it would still have to be Manchester United, I'm afraid. I just think they've got the depth in the squad, they've got the variation, they've got the talent. You know, to turn any team over on their day. What are you laughing at?
No, I just I backed them last week for the double for the Premier League and the Champions League with Leon, and I'm agreeing with you.
Right. For one,
that makes a change.
Darren, as a Liverpool fan, and finish with yourself, right? Premiership or Champions League? It's got to be the Prem, hasn't it?
Easy. I think it's got to be the Prem now, to be honest. Yeah, it seems to be focusing a lot, you know, more on it. So. It's got to be the Premiership.
And if I was to ask you, Rafa, you kept playing one player up front during the week. Very negative tactics at Anfield. Why are you so negative, Rafa?
No, I have players that come hard for us. Okay, we are talking, you know, keen, okay. He has quality, okay, but we have other players who can score goals. And we are talking Gerard and Alonso. They can score goals for sure. You know Riera, he can score, but sometimes you have no Torres. We only have one available striker and keen.
But Riera's only scored one goal, Rafa. Why did you keep playing him?
He's quality. He has quality. Keep doing it. Keep setting the goals up for the other players, and it's no problem. But we will see, but he is playing well for me.
Thanks very much, lad. To the four boys, especially Darren. Thank you.
Yeah.